Hey everybody, you know, I've been thinking lately, this could be the perfect time for all of us to become backyard astronomers. Just in case the thought of exploring the heavens above has got you excited, here are five things that you can see tonight with almost no effort. Number one, you could check out a meteor shower. You know, aside from a stretch of time between January and early April, almost every month of the year has a decent meteor shower, one where you could see at least 10 to 20 meteors per hour. That makes for about a meteor every 3 minutes. Now, that doesn't mean that you'll see a meteor every 3 minutes like clockwork. That just means you might see nothing for 10 minutes and then a bunch all at once. Well, you can trace most meteors in a meteor shower back to their radiant point, usually the constellation a particular meteor shower is named for. Odds are meteors will appear all over the sky throughout the night. Your best bet for seeing shooting stars on any given meteor shower is just to lie on your back and look up at the heavens during the darkest, clearest part of the night, closest to the predicted peak of a meteor shower. Number two, the Big Dipper. Now, if you don't know how to find the Big Dipper already, don't worry. This time of year is the easiest by far to find it in the sky. Basically, it's directly overhead for most of the night. So just look for a pot in the shape of four bright stars, about the dimensions of a shoebox, with three stars trailing off the side of one of the corners of that box. Those are the three stars of the handle of the Big Dipper. Number three, the North Star. Now, a lot of people mistakenly think the North Star is the brightest star in the sky. That's not what's special about it. What's unique about the North Star, otherwise known as Polaris, is it's lined up with the Earth's axis of rotation, the imaginary line that goes in the North Pole, out the South Pole, that the Earth turns on. So if you're at the North Pole, you could look straight up and see the North Star, and all the stars would rotate around it. To find the North Star, all you need to do is look along the two stars at the end of the pot of the Big Dipper. Draw an imaginary line between those two stars and continue that line past those two stars on the end of the pot of the Big Dipper to the next bright star. And that star will be Polaris, the North Star. Number four, Venus. A lot of people probably suspect that they've seen Venus in the sky at dusk or dawn, but what you might not know is, why is it so bright? Venus reflects about 70% of the light that hits it. In comparison, the Moon only reflects about 10% of that light. Because it's closer to the Sun than the Earth, Venus receives more light from the Sun. Also, Venus is often the closest planet to the Earth. It gets about 38 to 40 million kilometers away at its closest approach. Number five, the Moon. Now, hopefully you don't have a problem finding the Moon when it's out in the sky, but here's a look at some of the really cool things you can see with the naked eye and also some basic optical aid like binoculars or, if you have one, a telescope. Take a look on our spring guide to stargazing on jasperplanetarium.com. You can see all sorts of things to view on the Moon. We've got a map of the Moon and you'll see all sorts of amazing craters, mountain ranges, seas. So there's a look at five things you can easily see in the sky. Hopefully you get to see one or more of those in the near future. Until next time, clear skies, guys. For even more details, including maps, star charts, and further resources, check out our online guide to spring stargazing at jasperplanetarium.com.